tumors of the skull base are not totally uncommon. And when patients are stricken with these tumors, it's often very traumatic because, in general, the only approach to get to a tumor in the nasal cavity or the base of the brain is through large incisions on the face. Those lead to scarring and oftentimes functional deficits in terms of vision and the ability to smell and chew. What we've been doing at Mount Sinai for the past 10, maybe 12 years now, is endoscopic nasal approach to the skull base. And so what we do is we work with our neurosurgical team as part of the skull base team, accessing the base of the brain, not through a craniotomy where there's an incision made on the top of the head, the skin's peeled down, the skull is removed, and the brain is pushed back. Instead, we access it through the base of the brain through the nose. So my partners in neurosurgery and I each handle an endoscope. It goes through the nostril, and instead of making the craniotomy or opening to the brain up here, we make it through the nose. There's several advantages to that. First of all, the conventional approach requires pulling the brain back, and when you do that, you can suffer swelling of the brain, and that's particularly devastating to an older patient. That swelling can lead to cognitive problems and functional problems that can be permanent. When you go through the nose, there's no incisions at all on the face or the skull. There's no incisions on the scalp. And most importantly, there's no retraction of the brain, so there's no swelling. In particular, young patients and old patients tolerate this procedure exceptionally well. Instead of being left in the neurosurgical intensive care unit for 4 or 5 days, monitored very carefully, these patients typically go home in 2 days with nasal packing. Because they don't require any retraction of the brain, they very seldom have any cognitive or any functional deficit at all. So it's really been a wonderful advance for medicine and surgery to be able to access the base of the brain from underneath using two endoscopes in a collaborative approach with our neurosurgical colleagues.